The left's got a new talking point about Trump. Democrats accusing the Trump administration of covering up Trump advisors' connections to Russia. Now they are comparing it to Watergate. Listen to what Hillary Clinton's former campaign manager had to say.
I can tell you it is extremely strange to me that a member of any American presidential campaign would be speaking to Russian intelligence officials. And it's particularly bizarre given the fact that we know that Russian intelligence officials broke into the DNC, stole documents, and handed them to WikiLeaks for the purpose of hurting Hillary Clinton and helping Donald Trump. The parallels to Watergate here are eerie.
Well, here now, Hadley Heath Manning, Independent Women's Forum Senior Policy Analyst, and Neil Sroka, Democracy for America Communications Director. Thank you both for coming in. Neil, there are a couple of very important differences between what's happening now and Watergate. First of all, nobody's been convicted of anything right now. But Watergate was about a current president using the powers of his presidency to try to subvert the democratic process. Donald Trump was not president when this happened. Secondly, this was Russia breaking in to the DNC. It was not the Republican National Committee or the Trump campaign trying to break into the DNC. In fact, the one thing that the New York Times said, they even had to admit yesterday in their cover piece supposedly breaking a story about a connection between the GOP. They said the officials interviewed in recent weeks said that so far they had seen no evidence of cooperation between the Trump campaign and the Russians. Go ahead.
Well, that was in the original story. I read it that night. There were other parts that were updated. But let's be clear.
But they didn't change that point. There was no connection between the Trump administration and what the Russians were doing. They said that in the New York Times. There's a third paragraph.
No connection yet. I think there very well could be. I think there are reasons to believe that the Trump campaign had contacts with Russian agents over the course of the election, which does, you know, lead one to ask important questions. And that's the real thing here. There are lots of questions swirling around about Donald Trump, Donald Trump's campaign, and Donald Trump's White House's connection to Russia. And the question is whether or not there's going to be a full and complete independent investigation to verify that isn't the case.
America is dying to find some kind of connections. And if the journalistic enterprise that is most anxiously trying to get Donald Trump, the New York Times, was unable to find that connection, I don't think there's a connection to be found.
That's right. Can you imagine if this level of scrutiny were applied to every presidential administration instead of just the Trump administration? That would be a good thing. And it's good to be vigilant and to ask these questions, absolutely. But we have to base our investigations and our reporting on facts and not conjecture, as you said, David. So until we have the evidence, let's not blow out of proportion these exaggerated claims.
Hadley, Dan Henninger, hold on a second, Neil. Dan Henninger, Hadley, said today in the Wall Street Journal, and he's conservative. I've known Dan for years. He said that it could become Watergate-like if, in fact, this president becomes ensconced in the White House, kind of loses touch with what's going on around him. Do you see any chance of that happening? It's still so early in the administration, but go ahead.
Well, certainly it is on the president to make the public trust strong again, because after what happened with General Flynn, he has to reassure the public of all the facts and give as much information as he can in order to move forward with his agenda, because not only is this causing a huge distraction, but it's really raising, as Neil said, a lot of questions.
It is. All right. Meanwhile, the president is back with the people, or getting back with the people. President Trump is planning to hold a big rally in Florida this weekend. President tweeting, join me in Florida this Saturday at 5 p.m. for a rally at the Orlando Melbourne International Airport. Neil, anything wrong with this?
Listen, if he wants to continue to campaign like he did on the campaign trail, good luck with that.
Presidents are always campaigning. Come on, Neil, and have President Obama,
too. I think there's a little bit unusual with 27 days in, and he's already hosting another campaign rally. Listen, this is a guy who needs the adulation of the public, and he's just not getting it. I mean, over 55% of the country disapproves of him right now, and I think he just, after the week he's had this past week, he really needs to have some love.
What he is not getting is the adulation that President Obama got in the first full year of his presidency. For God's sakes, he got the Nobel Peace Prize before he'd done anything.
Right. Certainly the fans come from very different subsets of the American population. But, you know, we're always going to hear from people who have negative reactions more than we're going to hear from people who have positive reactions. I'd be surprised if these rallies turn up to the same level as the demonstrations against the Trump administration. But, yes, we live in a time of eternal campaigning, and so many Americans are tired of it.
And we've never seen a president with this kind of opposition. I would suggest,
Hadley, that he also needs that kind of contact with his support, because he's not getting anybody in the press backing him right now.
Well, that's right. And as I said, you're always going to hear more from the negative. Ask anybody who works in customer service. You don't get a lot of thank you phone calls.
Good point.
Hear from people who are having problems and who are upset with what they're getting.
Got to leave it at that. Neil and Hadley, great to have you both on. Thanks.